So students, let's write something about measurement of physical quantities. As we have discussed that in nature, most of the physical quantities are classified in two ways. These are scalars and vectors. There is one more way under which, there is one more category under which physical quantities can also be kept. These are tensors. Right now, we are not going to discuss anything about tensors. About tensors, we'll study in detail when you'll deal with advanced physics. Now, if we talk about scalars, these are the physical quantity which are represented just by magnitude. Only magnitude is sufficient to represent scalars, like we talk about work, speed, time, energy. These are the physical quantities which are denoted by symbols, say W, V, T, E. These are the scalars because we never have associated direction with time, work, speed and energy. And similar to this, we have another category under which we can categorize physical quantities. These are vectors. Vectors are those, these are the physical quantities which are represented by both magnitude and direction. Here we need magnitude and direction. Both magnitude and direction, if we know, we can completely define a physical quantity. Like if we talk about velocity, force, momentum, magnetic field, etc. So, these are the physical quantities which are measured or expressed completely by both their magnitude and direction. And the notation of these physical quantities are given by just placing an arrow over the symbol, like velocity is represented by V vector, it is represented by force vector, magnitude is P vector, magnetic field is denoted by B vector. If we just talk about V, F, P and B, when we just write the symbol of vector quantity, that means we are giving the magnitude of that physical quantity. If an arrow is written, then we must have direction associated with the physical quantity. Let's discuss about all these things in detail. Let's discuss representation of a vector. There are several ways by which a vector can be represented. Mainly here we are going to discuss two ways of representing a vector. Later in this chapter we'll study one more interesting way to represent a vector. Right now mainly we are going to focus first on pictorial representation. And the second is mathematical representation. If we just talk about representation, so we need to represent only two things. One is magnitude and the other is direction. In pictorial as well as in mathematical representation, our main motive is to represent magnitude and direction of a physical quantity or the vector which is representing a physical quantity in a systematic way by which we can analyze those physical quantities in different type of calculations and analysis.